about it, mobile social networking really brings together some of the hottest areas of emerging media. Mobile, social media, and then you overlay location. Now, location is what's killer in this. Because all of a sudden now, brands can target people where they are. And that's leading us to that holy grail of marketing, of getting that person in the right location at the right time with that offer that they're going to be most receptive to. And so hopefully our panelists today, or some of the leading experts in this space, can help us figure out how as advertisers and marketers, we can start leveraging this space.
I feel like location, when your phone is in your pocket and it follows you around, it should kind of already know where you are and sort of even behaviorally what you're doing. So for example, if you're in a movie theater and your phone's idle for a couple hours, and obviously your phone will know you're probably at a movie theater, it might even know the movie that you're at or a list of movies that you're at. As soon as you get up, why don't you just get a passive ping that says, hey, we think you just watched a movie, which one was it, and do you like it or do you not like it? Same with dinner, same with lunch, same with any of these activities, running, etc. Instead of making the active sort of behavior of opening the app, finding a venue, checking in, it should be passive. That's just one of my opinions.
It's our awesome responsibility to build tools for consumers that handle location and privacy in obvious ways. You know, it's easy to get carried away and to sort of post things that you might not want to share. You know, if you're out at 3 o'clock in the morning on a Tuesday night, do you want your boss to know it? You might want your friends to know that, but it's cool, you want to come find you, but do you want, you know, other people to know those things? So being able to real time very easily decide who to share things with, conscious of how that goes out, and we have a responsibility to make you aware of what's happening and to make that easy, which on a mobile phone creates, you know, sort of tension of sort of functionality. If you look at, you know, Facebook's sort of privacy share settings, you know, it's fantastically complicated. If you want to set up, you know, things in great detail, you can, but nobody does, and they certainly don't do it at 2 o'clock in the morning in a bar. So it's, you know, we have to be sort of real time with those things. One of the things that we found, you know, probably everybody in this room, you know, has an interest in this space. They might be, you know, using one of these services or thinking about it. You know, there are lots of people out there in the world that are frightened of the things that we do. You know, the notion of sharing your location to lots of people is a sort of no-no. There's a sort of knee-jerk reaction of that being quite frightening. For some people, rightly so. You know, if you're a teenage woman, do you want to sort of tell the world where you are? I'm in this bar, I'm in this bar, I'm in this bar. You've got to handle those things with responsibility. So one of the things we've looked at and continue to look at is how do we open up our service to people that are taking that first step. You know, so maybe I don't want to share it with my Facebook friends, I don't want to share it with my BrightKite friends, I don't have any, so you know, have people, you know, built up. But I do have six friends in my address book of my phone and I want to share my location with them as we're going out and see. So how do I think of my, you know, my phone address book is my social graph at that point, and how do I share location? You know, lots of phone calls, lots of text messages contain where are you, what are you doing? You know, how do we kind of accelerate that? How do we pull that forwards, you know, in a very private way? I think it's important to lots of consumers.
Mobile advertising in general, you know, a lot of us come from the space. Rob and I had our last companies were about 8 years ago, in pocket and edge, one of the first mobile advertising agencies. So, you know, I think when the mobile ad banner came out, we all kind of bit our tongue and said, this thing kind of sucks. It doesn't have the same, you know, relative intensity that you have online, you know, average media. Even Steve Jobs agrees with us now, I think. But, you know, that's changing. I think in really integrated environments on mobile social networks, so it's not the banner ad. It's a sponsorship. You know, I think Foursquare with Pepsi with their leaderboard. You guys did a great job on that, and now the upcoming Pepsi Loot implementation too is great. But for brands to get integrated, to get sponsored, you know, we're talking to brands to literally just completely take over our app on weekends or during week-long periods are much more effective than the standard banner.
What we've tried to do with Foursquare since the beginning, like I mentioned, is to try to change behavior. Can we get people to, if we gave them a list of 10 pizza shops in the city, and we said, you're going to get some sort of, you're going to get a token, you're going to get a pizza badge, you're going to hit all five, or all 10, or 5 out of 10, whatever it might be. And the idea is, will people actually go and do it? And we realized, we saw more than once, that people really do want to go do that. People want to get a gym rat badge, they want to get rewarded for going to the gym 10 times in 1 month, and they want to show off the fact that they're actually unique in their in doing this. They want to show off their personality to some degree. And they're willing to share this data without any other kind of invasive technique. So one of the things you can work with advertising and marketing on top of all this is that what you should be trying to do maybe is to try to encourage certain type of behavior or to reward their existing kind of lifestyles and their existing
works. We believe it's incentives, real world rewards and incentives is what's been working. And then one idea of the example is we did a Jack in the Box and gave away a free curly fries, you know, coupon, you go in. And when we stopped that campaign, we were getting people calling us, like, what happened to the curly fries? You know, so it was enough demand where people were sort of getting it. So
that was me.
Was that you're getting the curly fries? Okay, there you go. So we're, you know, things that have real value, you know, to the user that can build brand loyalty, more frequency into the stores. That's what we see resonating. The other thing is we've seen really well with deals. You know, Groupon's done really well with deals, but you know, some people are just into that. So we're looking at, you know, doing more of that really highly hyper local relevant around deals has been possible.
Rewards is good, but not everybody wants to give away free beer or half price frappuccinos. You know, a lot of brands, you know, advertising is still cool. And the ability, you know, local ads are, you know, you've got Yellow Pages, you've got local press, you've got outdoor if you're a national brand, but for independent merchants, that's tough. I think the space that, you know, we're just starting, but I think, you know, collectively we're going to revolutionize is local advertising for local businesses. The ability to go into an AdSense like UI and say, okay, I'll buy, you know, people in my restaurant on a Tuesday night for $12 a seat, you know, on a sort of CPA basis and drive people into my restaurant. I was going to fill two tables on that level. Your ability to sort of to target people that are both mobile and doing some relevant activity on their phones and move, you know, traffic from one business to another, really powerful for brands, just something that doesn't exist before. I think that's a huge market. But also for consumers, that should be great. You know, the Hal's example of, you know, I'm in a movie theater, I'm going to go and do something afterwards. Probably historically we can say, usually I go for a beer after I go and see a movie, and therefore, you know, somebody trying to attract my attention with an offer around somewhere to drink is good for me as a consumer, but also powerful for the brands.
I think one point that's relevant to a lot of the people in this room is that consumers are going to determine what wins. And it sounds obvious, but this is a new development, like consumerization of the enterprise. I know we're looking at applying geo-social networks at companies and brands and existing communities, but what we're hearing from company decision makers is that, like, we're going to wait and see what the consumers decide to do. So I think this is a small point, but like these guys, these four guys here, like they're gonna be the first ones on the front lines hearing about what things work with consumers. And whatever gets legs with the consumers is gonna move over to the brand side and the company side.